we are positioned behind turn two, so there may be a little bit of a delay when we're identifying the respective jammers. Here we go. Gameplay begins. Coming into turn one with somewhat of a lead, that would be number 43 for Dublin. Oh, but coming through now for Auld Reekie, that's Rosie Peacock. They are one of the premier jammers for the Auld Reekie squad. They take an inside line and are forced back. Meanwhile, the Auld Reekie defense playing havoc with Stabba. Nice rollback there. Yes, and Rosie Peacock continues her onslaught. That's through the pack again. Auld Reekie making a statement early, Elota. This is 10 to nothing in favor of the Edinburgh team. Oh, Auld, that could have been a dangerous play right there for Rosie Peacock, but they evade the back block, the penalty box, full of Auld Reekie blockers right now, but that doesn't seem to hurt Rosie Peacock's progress. Okay, thank you. Thank you for that, Elota. 18 to nothing after the first jam in favor of the Auld Reekie Roller Girls, or ARG, as I've heard them referred to. And Dublin now with a jammer standing in the penalty box, a full four wall setting up defensively, both teams with all their blockers, and Dublin will have to join the fray with the jammer. They are coming out right now, pushing the front of the pack, however, is Sasha DeBolt-Pisco for Auld Reekie. Dublin defense doing a very good job on Sasha right now. A bump out there by Brutally Locock is going to roll Sasha back to behind the pivot line. No clear advantage for either jammer. We have 10 contestants. Oh, and now a star pass, Elota. That's Mania now with the star for Dublin, and she is, oh, she splits that wall brutally. Oh, my, Mania putting up a quick 5 points. Dublin reasserting themselves after that first jam. It's now 18-5 in favor of Auld Reekie, and Mania off the star pass, putting up five more, 18-10 now. Sasha DeBolt-Pisco still not through on an initial pass. Oh. Mania with a sweet athletic move around turn two on the inside. Now she's going to call off the jam. We're seeing if she's got any more. No, but a 15-point pass, Elota. Oh, my goodness. Well, you know, there's only my research says less than 300 miles separate these two teams in a geographical location. Kind of funny that they travel to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania to face off in the D2 playoffs. But there you go.
Yeah, that's a great place to
You know it. And, of course, those of you watching in the UK or other areas of the world may or may not know that Pittsburgh, one of the premier sports towns in the U.S. Okay, we got Danosaurus Rex now with the lead jam status for Auld Reekie, but in hot pursuit is Bloody Harry for Dublin. That's going to force a call off, and it appears to be a scoreless jam, Elota. Well, We got a fist bump on the jam line for the respective jammers. We'll have those jammers identified for you in just a second. Again, we are located behind turn two, so it's not always easy to tell the jammers immediately, but we have a Dublin lead jammer, and that is number 800, Thea. Again, Thea is approaching the pack on a scoring pass. Rosie Peacock, though, is coming through. Rosie Peacock stealing 4 points. Thea picked up three before being forced to call it off. Rosie Peacock, sneaky fast.
So what we had called originally as a third jam being a 0-0 score, Reekie actually picked up three. So they're going to add an additional four for this jam here, bringing the score Reekie 25, Dublin 19. We're just about 6.5 minutes in.
Okay, Dublin now with only two blockers on the track. This is an opportunity for Auld Reekie. It's Sasha DeBull-Pisco again wearing the star for Arg, and she is through. Lead jammer Sasha DeBull-Pisco. Oh, and another star pass. This time it's going to Dashing Trudy Snow. No, it's Star Stash. Star Stash for Trudy, and that'll force a call-off as she quickly got back into the pack. It's a 3-point pickup for Auld Reekie.
Snowy had a great jump of the outside of turn one. I don't know if you guys were able to see that at home, but that was pretty fantastic.
Yeah, this is, again, if you're just joining us, in the black is Auld Reekie. They have 28 points. Dublin hanging tough with 19. 23 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first period, and we are getting ready to go for jam number six. It's been back and forth, both teams showing some prowess. Oh, and talk about jamming prowess right now, though. That's number 15, Dinosaurus Rex for Auld Reekie. She's clearly in control of this jam right now. Lead jammer and engaging the pack on a scoring pass coming up to the pivot line. The Dublin jammer having a difficult time right now. This is Bloody Harry with the star for Dublin. Nice defensive work there by Pippa for Dublin, rolling back Dinosaurus Rex.
Auld Reekie with a really solid race triangle there, not allowing Dublin's jammer, Bloody Harry, to make her way through at all, forcing a star pass off to number 95.
That's Mania again, and Mania got the benefit of that last score pass. Now, Mania showing quick re-engagement. Boy, she got around the pack in a heartbeat. We've got to see 5 points put up for Auld Reekie. Looking for the point total for Dublin. It appears no points on that jam.
All right, so about 8 minutes into this first half of the first game, of the first day, of the first tournament play of the offseason. All those firsts, I love it. We've got Auld Reekie on top, 33 to Dublin's 21. Auld Reekie coming out with a really strong first jam and then slowly building 3 or 4 points per jam since then.
Yes, and we're back to the action. This is pushing the front of the pack now, but getting bumped out by Chancleta. The Auld Reekie jammer regrouping. Oh boy, that inside line is just nailed down by the Dublin defense, Elota.
Yeah, absolutely. Nothing's getting past there on turn one, that's for sure.
Well, you see one of the premier blockers. Oh, lead jammer now going to Rosie Peacock. They are through. One of the stalwarts for the Auld Reekie defense is Temple of Doom. And she was holding that defensive line. Okay, through 4-5, we have Rosie Peacock still looking to get through on the initial pass, as Jack Clayton now picking up the start pass.
Rosie Peacock is feeding unopposed right now. We've got Thea in the penalty box for Dublin. It's the second power jam, I think, that they've given up so far today.
That's correct. And Rosie Peacock certainly knows what to do with that situation. It's a 3-2 pack advantage in favor of Auld Reekie, and here come the replacements as well for Auld Reekie. Crazy Legs coming out of the box. So, 5 more points put up by Rosie Peacock. Auld Reekie 21 Dublin, and this jam is a big statement for Auld Reekie.
We've got Thea out of the box for Dublin, back at it. 15 points though on the board for Rosie already.
Yeah, and they have no reason to stop at this point, as Thea continuing to be contained, now taken down by Jess Little, my long-lost cousin from Edinburgh.
I meant to ask you about that. I'm glad you brought it up.
I was watching a lot of video coming into this, and I was looking forward to seeing Jess Little play because she gets a lot of star passes and does very well with them. But that's a 20-point jam for Rosie Peacock, taking Auld Reekie to 53, Dublin 21. Just got over 10 minutes into the game, though. Dublin, if patterns show to be accurate, Dublin has another jam in them right now. Here we go, back to jam number 8. Oh, and Dublin quickly out in front. That's Dashing Trudy Snow, lead jammer for the ladies in blue. Dublin in blue, if you're just joining us, and Auld Reekie in black. And Dashing Trudy Snow on a scoring pass right now. I believe that's Sasha DeBull Pisco being throttled right now by the Dublin defense. The Auld Reekie defense, no slouch at the front of that pack either, though, Aleta.
Yeah, you know, I was going to say that really turn one is kind of the make or break spot here on the track so far this morning. If you're not out by the time you hit turn one, you're going to get stuck there for a
while. Well, we have a star pass now for Auld Reekie. That's going to miss. Collie check. Nice bump out on the defensive end by Pope John Brawl, and Snowy's got a decision to make right now for Dublin. It's a 5-point pickup for Dashing Trudy Snow. Dublin now on 25, Auld Reekie 53.
Yeah, and you know, Dublin was only able to pick up 5 points on that pass because when she came around for her second scoring pass, she was stopped really right there, all the action. Did the pack get past turn two? That's what I want to know.
Good question. Good question, Aleta. I don't think that the pack ever did. Okay, now Dublin making an on-the-fly adjustment, and they're saying Mania did so well with those star passes. We're just going to jam her right off the spot, and that may be a very good idea. Wearing the star now for Auld Reekie, we have
Danosaurus Rex.
Rex. Thank you, Aleta.
Yeah,
again.
It's getting a little hard here.
Okay, Mania gets through for Dublin. Dublin with 26, Auld Reekie with 53, but Danosaurus Rex threw the pack as well on the initial. Mania's trying to make it around. Ooh, dangerous play there. Mania grabbing a hold of the opponent's midriff to kind of pull herself around to get a couple more. No points awarded on that pass.
Yeah, no points. Yeah, that's kind of tough. We've got the score here remaining at 53, Auld Reekie, Dublin 26. Auld Reekie picking up lead jammer privilege. 6 out of the, let's see, we are at jam number 9. So really kind of owning that. You can kind of see that in the score. They also have an incredibly strong defense that's really not letting anyone pass.
Again, yes, between Pope John Brawl and Temple of Doom, along with Jess Little, yes, very capable defense. Speaking of defense, though, Auld Reekie sends a blocker to the penalty box and through lead jammer Bloody Harry for Dublin. Oh, a cutting the track penalty going against Rosie Peacock. They will have to sit down. Power jam Dublin, 26 points right now, 53 for Auld Reekie.
Yeah, Auld Reekie, this is the first power jam that they've given up so far, and we've got Bloody Harry out picking up lead jammer for Dublin.
Okay, she's got 5 already, 3 blockers on the track for both teams. Here comes Bloody Harry on a second scoring pass. The inside line handled very well by Simply the Beast. Inside line handled again. Bloody now looking outside, and she's able to hold on to her right skate on the straightaway. That's 5 more for Dublin. Now Dublin with 36, 53, Auld Reekie. The power jam is over. There's a star pass on the Auld Reekie side, and that's going now to number 12, Simply the Beast. Okay. jam is called off, an 11-point pickup for Dublin, and we have a timeout called by Dublin.
All right, we've got Reekie at 53, Dublin at 37, about 15 minutes left to go in this first half. We've seen a number of star passes so far, a total of 5 in 10 jams. We seem to really be doing exactly what we would expect them to be, forcing the other teams to call it off. We've seen a handful of Dublin's kind of picked up their score here, 37 points. We have an 11-point jam this last one, and then I think there was also many had a 15-point jam pretty early on, so most of their scoring coming from those two particular.
Okay, and I misspoke. That timeout was actually called for by Auld Reekie. Not exactly the 16-point difference. Auld Reekie in the lead right now. Not exactly what you might predict with a number one seed versus a number 16 seed. However, Auld Reekie playing without one of their star jammers, Charlotte Patterson. The team wants to say hello. Charlotte Patterson is a mom. Her kids started school this week, and the woman has priorities, and, you know, much respect for that. Auld Reekie battling nonetheless right now, leading Dublin 53-37. Jam number 11 is underway. Pushing the front of the pack is Rosie Peacock for Dublin. Excuse me, for Auld Reekie, but coming from behind is Thea for Dublin. Thea, lead jammer now. Oh, excuse me, that's not Rosie Peacock. That's Dinosaurus Rex. She's called off for cutting the track. Elota, another power jam for Dublin.
Yeah, things are really evening up here, both between power jams, star passes, lead jammer statuses. So really, I think everyone's just kind of working their stuff out here. We're going to see some really great games from here on out.
Oh, boy. Pushing the front of the pack now in turn three is Thea, but the Auld Reekie defense pretty stingy on this power jam.
Oh, absolutely. They are there in turn four. It looks like Thea is through. That'll be 5 points for her.
Well, Dublin very happy to get 5 at a time right now. They're now just 11 down with 14 minutes to play.
We've got Dinosaurus standing in now, just about to enter the track here on turn four.
Okay, and Dublin defense ready for her. We don't see her yet on the monitor. Okay, back into the action. Again, this Auld Reekie defense very frugal, making Thea work for every single point.
Yeah, Dublin kind of sent an offensive blocker up to try to mix that up, try that again. Doesn't seem to be working.
No, trying
to fall back to it.
Trying to pry open that braced wall. It's not an easy thing to do. That's Stabba right now. Oh, and this time Stabba comes through, trying to make just a little bit of disruption to let Thea get out and score some more, but now Thea's going to be rolled back by none other than Temple of Doom for Auld Reekie. That'll prompt the call off, but 5 more put up by Dublin. Okay, 47 Dublin, 53 Auld Reekie.
Well, both defenses there, and still end up that jam, doing a great job, really not allowing either of the blockers to move forward. That braced two wall from Auld Reekie up front, and then Dublin really doing a great job.
Oh, yeah. I mean, well, you know, these teams, despite the fact that they've only played once in the past year, have played at EuroClash in 2017, 2016. They know each other to have watched them. Dashing Trudy Snow, lead jammer Dublin. This is 3 lead jams in a row for Dublin. Okay, through the pack now for Auld Reekie is Rosie Peacock. They find a hole on the inside of turn one and a quick steal. Is this a power jam?
Yeah, it is a power jam. Being sent to the penalty box for a cut track. Dashing Trudy Snow spending that penalty time there in the box.
Boy, Rosie Peacock is like the assassin for Auld Reekie right now. Every time they need a big jam, it seems like Rosie is there to provide it. Here comes the offense right now. It's Miss Kalichek making room on this straightaway. The power jam is over. Here comes Dashing Trudy Snow. She'll be picking up points. This is a full 2-minute jam.
Dublin has picked up, prior to being sent to the box, 5 of the last lead jammer privileges. So we're really kind of seeing that evening out here, despite the fact that Rosie Peacock has 15 points under their belt.
Yeah, Rosie Peacock just seems to score in multiples of five. They've got a real nose for the big jam. There's still 33 seconds left in this jam. And boy, you don't want to give that Auld Reekie defense time to set up. Dashing through the snow is now trying to make it through on the first scoring pass. Rosie, meanwhile, has four more. Auld Reekie now with 72, Dublin with 51, 14 seconds left. Here comes Rosie again, pushing on the inside, and they managed to stay in bounds. Beautiful play. No pass, no penalty. Results in 4 points awarded. Auld Reekie finishes up the jam at 76. Dublin finishes it up with 53.
Wow, 10.5 minutes left to go.
23 points.
Yeah, I don't know if you can hear the house announcer here, but yes, he's echoing exactly how I feel. 23 points for Auld Reekie there, and Rosie Peacock.
Well, I'm sure that Charlotte Patterson is very happy to see her teammate Rosie Peacock picking up the mantle and really running with it. We're back to jam 13 now. Auld Reekie 76 and 53 for Dublin, and Sasha DeBull Pisco lead jammer for Reekie.
Blake Perry wearing the star for Dublin, getting stuck there in turn one.
Boy, Sasha now with a natural grand slam, as they call it, putting up 5 points. Now through the pack, Bloody Harry completes the initial pass. Sasha looking for a little more, bumped up and going long, is going to pay off for Dublin this time as Bloody Harry puts up four. Nice defense by Dublin now. They're holding off, pushing out Sasha. Sasha calls off the jam. She did get three, but four more for Dublin, and that takes Dublin to 61, Auld Reekie to 84. Both teams getting 8 points on that one.
And we've got 9 minutes left to go in the first half. This seems like actually they were held scoreless for five jams the same time that Dublin was picking up five lead jams in a row.
That's right, and then Rosie Peacock came on the track and everything changed. Okay, we got a Dublin lead jammer right now. That will be Thea. Thea with a good percentage, I would think, and picking up lead right now, wearing the star for Auld Reekie, pushing through on the outside now. Is number 15, Danosaurus Rex, but Danosaurus called for a multiplayer block on the jammer. A rare call, but it does happen. Power jam Dublin with 8 minutes 25 seconds. Thea on a scoring pass, but again, that Auld Reekie defense, you give them time and they're going to make your life miserable.
She sees the inside there of turn 2 open. She is through that. 5 points for Dublin.
Very good. Both teams with 4 blockers on the track. You see Mania now kind of leading the defense, talking to Malabruz Stacy. Here comes Thea. Mania looking for an opportunity to play some offense. But, nice work. A little bit of smart play by Dublin getting the no-pack call. But immediately, Auld Reekie recovers.
We've got Danosaurus Rex, it looks like, coming back onto the track. Backed up into turn 3.
Power jam is over, and Mania is pushing bodies around for Dublin. But Thea is still locked up. Mania doing everything they can to get some offensive work. Now completing the initial pass is Danosaurus Rex. That's going to force the call off, I would think. And it does. Yes, Thea calls off. But hey, good work by Thea. Picks up 10 points. Still, that Auld Reekie defense is very stingy.
Yeah, you know, they have that great, like, brace two wall, brace tripod, whatever you want to call it, wherever you are. They usually does a great job up in the front of the pack. It got a little bit disorganized, though, towards the end there. So it didn't certainly work out to Thea's favor.
13-point game now. Auld Reekie 84, 71 for Dublin. Rosie Peacock on the jam line for Auld Reekie. They are the ones who have been making it happen right now. for the team in black. And pushing the front again, lead jammer, Rosie Peacock. Rosie Peacock, the one skater that Dublin seems not to have an answer to. Dashing Trudy Snow stashes the star, completes the initial pass. Ooh, and... Oh, Rosie Peacock now called off for cutting the track. This is a brave new world for Dublin. Power jam for Dashing Trudy Snow.
Power jam. 13 points. Not an insurmountable lead there for Auld Reekie when you talk about a power jam.
Not at all. 6 minutes to go in the first period. And Dashing Trudy Snow. Trudy Snowy still locked up, though. And, okay, they find an outside line now. Jess Little holding her off. Nice work by my long-lost cousin, Jess Little. Amazing defensive stand up at the front of the pack is going to roll back Snowy. The penalty is over. The power jam concludes. Here comes number 50, the difference maker so far for Auld Reekie, Rosie Peacock. Rosie Peacock was called off, so they will have to complete the initial pass. Nice defensive work so far by Dublin, rolling back Rosie to behind turn four. But tell you what, not a lot of scoring opportunities for Snowy right now. Dashing Trudy Snow. Peacock was on a scoring pass. My bad. That's 4 points, and you have to wonder whether Trudy might have wanted to call that one off. You don't want to give Rosie Peacock an opportunity to score a lot.
Yeah, at this point, she just got through, put her 5 points on the board to at least get something there before calling it off. It was a hard-fought fight for 5 points.
Boy, howdy.
That'll bring Dublin to 76, Auld Reekie to 88 with 4.5 minutes left to go in the first half here.
That's just been a very, very quick moving first period. 16-point lead for Auld Reekie. They're on 92, 4 minutes, 22 seconds. Dublin with 76, and here we go. Jam 16 is underway.
It looks like that is a section where the star for Auld Reekie and Bloody Harry are star for Dublin in the blue. Bloody Harry out in front, picking up the ball.
Okay, both jammers through now. Bloody Harry has about a, not even a half a track advantage. And, ooh, boy.
Yeah, that has to be outside there at turn two.
Yes, and Bloody Harry just shakes her head and says, I'm not going to let that happen again. Because four stolen by Sasha DeBull-Pisco on that one. And Dublin can't really afford to let that kind of thing happen in a game where they're playing against the number one seed.
You know, we talked about the number one seed versus the number 16 seed, but we are lining up for jam number 17. Lead jammer status, 8-8 for these two teams. Star pass is pretty even. The same thing with power jams given up. So the matchup on paper, penalty-wise, and lead jammer, pretty even between these two teams and not a big point differential.
Yes, it is. Mania wearing the star. Oh, Mania bumped out at the last second. Nice defensive play again by Temple of Doom. Boy, that Temple of Doom, a difference maker on defense. And wearing the star for Auld Reekie is Danosaurus Rex, and neither team giving up an inch right now. Both teams at full strength. It's a scrum, but coming through first is Danosaurus Rex, lead jammer Auld Reekie. Auld Reekie with a chance to go over 100 with 2 minutes and 36 seconds left. Mania completes the initial pass, scoring pass now for Danosaurus Rex. And, you know, one thing I've seen so far is both teams have a propensity to push it and want to go long. That time, Danosaurus Rex called it off just in time, picked up 1 point, nothing for Dublin.
So that'll bring Auld Reekie rather to 97 with that 1 point. Dublin with 77, 2 minutes left to go. And you know, you had mentioned in the last jam about both teams being at full strength. It's been a revolving door, it seems, of penalties. So once we get into the half, we'll be able to kind of give you a recap of the penalties. But we've got, let's see, this college check for our Reekie with four penalties so far. We've not completed the first half.
Okay. Oh, another penalty assessed. Now to Rosie Peacock, power jam for Dublin. Now two skaters in the penalty box for Auld Reekie. Dublin at full strength. Dublin with 77, Auld Reekie with 97. Here comes the Dublin offense. Auld Reekie, no, there is a nice sweep by Valdemort. And that will result in a 5-point scoring pass for Dublin. Dublin now down by 15 with a minute 16 to go. Second scoring pass for Thea now. Boy, I think Dublin really needs to get in there and play some offense. That's exactly what they're doing. The power jam is over. And ooh, Thea is still on the track. Initial pass for Rosie Peacock. And I think Dublin right now need to be sure that Rosie Peacock does not add to their scoring as Thea on the second scoring pass alertly calls it off. Yeah. We have 40 seconds left in the period. Dublin on 86, Auld Reekie on 97. What a game.
Yeah, that Dublin bench was very, very aware of where Rosie was.
That was a 9-point jam for Thea. Coming up to the jam line again. Are they running Rosie twice in a row? No, I don't believe so. I think this is Danosaurus Rex again for... Excuse me. Sasha DeBull Pisco wearing the star for Auld Reekie. And we are... It's Dash and Trudy Snow will be jamming for Dublin. This will be the final jam of the period. The period clock is on zero, but no clear advantage for either jammer.
It actually looks like we've got Crash Collision Course wearing the star for Auld Reekie, which I believe is their first time wearing the star so far. Yep.
Well, Auld Reekie is hemorrhaging blockers right now. Two sent to the penalty box. Dashing Trudy Snow gets lead jammer for Dublin. So finishing off the first period, a scoring opportunity for Dublin. It's Temple of Doom now on the defensive end, and oh, Dashing Trudy Snow almost completed the apex jump, not quite able to do it. Temple of Doom seems to be everywhere now, and there's that star pass to Jess Little that I was telling you about, Elota. Okay, calling it off alertly is Snowy. That's 4 points for Dublin, and we go into halftime. It's a 7-point game. The number 16 seed Dublin team is at 90, Auld Reekie at 97, and wow. And you are watching the 2017 International Wftda Division II Playoffs and Championships. Championships will be someday. Yeah, here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, one of my favorite cities in the Northeast U.S. In any event, Elota, we've got ourselves a barn burner for this first game, Auld Reekie and Dublin. And penalties may play a very important role as we proceed to this second period. What's the status of the penalties for the play for both teams?
So the penalty box is getting a lot of action so far in this first half. It seemed like any time you turned around, there was someone either headed to the box or coming back from it. But kind of even there. Auld Reekie with 19 penalties overall. Two skaters with four each. That's Crazy Legs and Ms. Kalichek. But looking at some of the stats that we've kind of gotten together, we would see them on the higher end of penalties. And then for Dublin, coming in with 22 penalties so far in the first half total. Two skaters with three, that's Valdemort and Stava. But let's talk about Rosie Peacock with those three jammer penalties there.
It's the only thing they've done wrong is pick up a couple of penalties. Otherwise, they are just on fire scoring.
And it's a total, I think, of four power jams that Auld Reekie has given up so far in the first half. Three of them for Dublin. So pretty even matchup there. So we've got 7 points separating these two teams. Dublin, the 16th seed. Auld Reekie, the number one, but it's been an incredible matchup.
Auld Reekie's going to be very happy to come out of here with a win if they can. And that's not assured at this point whatsoever. It's a 7-point game. Join us in the party on Talk to WFTDA. On Twitter, has told us that Dublin's going to make them sorry. They second-guessed them on my bracket. Well, who knows? At this point, it's a 7-point game. We're getting ready to start the second period. And again, looking over at the penalty box, this could augur well for Auld Reekie as two Dublin blockers in the penalty box to start this first jam of the second period. Sasha DeBolt-Pisco immediately picks up lead jammer for Auld Reekie. And Auld Reekie defense is very stingy. Sasha on her own now. This is Bloody Harry, I believe, wearing the star for Dublin. She's able to fight her way through, but Sasha already on a scoring pass, bumped outside nicely by Brutally Locock, and it forces a cut. Now we have a power jam for Dublin.
Yeah, Bloody Harry has the 30-second penalty to burn there, and then we're going to see a full 2-minute jam go on right now. Bloody Harry with a 5-point scoring pass, looking to make a second one, but knocked out of bounds there on the outside of turn two.
Yeah, that was Skinner alive with that alert defensive play for Auld Reekie. If you're just joining us, you missed a great first period. Dublin in the blue and Auld Reekie in the black. And now we've got 4-on-4 in the blocking hemisphere, but jammer standing for Auld Reekie in the penalty box. That's 5 more. Dublin now at 100. We've got a 1-point game. Of course, Sasha may have taken some points to the penalty box with her, so we'll see about that. Nice defense on the inside straight away by Brutally Locock. And now both defenses are able to set up a little bit more. Friendly Fire takes Sasha down, but she's able to regroup. She puts up 4, and of course this is going to be a 2-minute jam. Neither jammer can call this thing off. 15 seconds left on the period clock, or excuse me, on the jam clock. Ooh, we're cutting the track now against Bloody Harry, and this jam's going to end in a power jam situation for Auld Reekie.
Yeah, Auld Reekie started there in the penalty box with an early penalty for Sasha. Comes out of the box, though, puts up a strong number of points, a total of 11, bringing Auld Reekie to 108. Dublin, though, 14 points on the board in that jam, bringing them to 104. 4 points separating these two teams now, and we're just 3 minutes in.
Yeah, 27:39 on the period clock right now, and it'll be a power start for Auld Reekie. And who would you send to the jam line in that situation? I'd send Rosie Peacock, and that's exactly what Auld Reekie did.
Yep. Rosie just needs to stay out of the box, make their way out of turn one cleanly, pick up lead, and do good work. Not to the inside, though, of turn two.
The inside by Lana Payne. Nice penalty kill right now for Dublin. Dublin really needs this penalty kill. Oh, and a back block is the call on Rosie Peacock. They have to sit down in the penalty box. Sprung from that same penalty box is Bloody Harry for Dublin. Power jam for the gals in blue. But again, this Auld Reekie defense is very difficult to get through. Bloody Harry does so. Lead jammer, Dublin.
Yeah, Auld Reekie just really kind of holding her back there in the backstretch as long as they could. She spun around to the outside and picked up lead.
Okay, on a scoring pass now, here comes the Dublin offense all at once, trying to make a little bit of room for Bloody Harry. But again, one of the things that we've seen all throughout this game is how hard it is to get through the Dublin defense, or excuse me, the Auld Reekie Dublin
but
defense.
Let's talk about that right there, that Dublin defense, those two blockers there holding Rosie back. Rosie really having to fight and push to get through.
That's right. Coming out of the penalty box, they were looking for points right away, and we've got a tie game, Alota. 108-108, 25:54 to go in the second period. This is a 1 versus a 16 on the seeding bracket, and it is quite a contest.
We've got a lean crowd here right now watching this in person. I don't know about at home, but I hope that you're listening, whether you're here in the States and it's early morning and you're at work, or you're over in Europe and listening to this and it's mid-afternoon. Have a beer for me, because I wish I could have a beer and cheer this game on. It's fantastic.
Mania bumped just inside alertly at the last second by Pope John Brawl, but Mania back up. Is this lead? It is.
Yeah.
It's a Dublin lead for Mania. And if you are enjoying the game and it's the afternoon, hey, just tell your boss, Gretchen Little said, have a good time. No pass, no penalty. The call, 4 points awarded. Dublin now in the
takes
lead.
Takes the lead, yes.
112-108 with the star now, Danosaurus Rex.
And I'm going to say this is the first lead change. All right, so yeah, Auld Reekie came in really strong in the first half. The first jam, I think, picked up 18 points, I believe. The second jam of the first half was countered by Dublin with 15 points. And right now we have got a lead change.
That's right, Dublin 116, Auld Reekie 108. And if you're only listening, I know you're having a good time and we're happy to have you along, but just think how much better it would be if you were to purchase that complete package, and we'll tell you more about it in just a second. We've got another Dublin lead jammer. That's Thea this time. Sasha DeBol Pisco playing stalker from behind, and as Thea has plenty of respect for Sasha, calls off the jam. Scoreless jam, Belota.
Yeah, you know, not a bad idea to call that off there when Auld Reekie's jammer is hot on your heels. Dublin still holds the lead, 117 to Auld Reekie 108. About 7 minutes in.
Okay, we've got Bloody Harry lining up for Dublin.
Dublin has picked up the last three lead jams, and we're just four jams in. So official, holding on to that and taking the lead.
Sorry. Yeah. Official timeout now on the track. Elota, why don't we find that information?
Yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah.
I mean, listening is great. It's certainly easy at work. So thank you very much for listening here. But it's not too late to get the high-quality auto feed for this weekend and for the entire season of post-season play there. It's just $20 U.S. dollars for both tracks. And again, keep in mind that the 2017 International Wftda D2 Playoffs and Champions is a two-track deal this weekend.
Right.
Playoffs and championships all in one. So $20 for this weekend, but it's $80 for the season pass, and that equates to less than $1 a game.
It does, and essentially, if you do it now, you get champs, D1 champs for free.
And buy now.
Yeah,
buy operators now, are standing by.
You will not experience buyer's remorse, because I'm probably the worst play-by-play announcer that you'll hear.
No, I'll be doing it later.
TV. Oh,
yeah,
okay.
No, you're fine.
Well,
yeah.
The two of us, we're like, you know, we're starting slow so that by the time you really get into the games in the weekend, you'll really be enjoying yourself. But how about it? This has been an amazing game so far. Of course, Dublin now, 23-37 left in this second period. I guess the only thing that I would say to Violent Bob right now is you got to keep the pedal to the metal. This Auld Reekie team is not the kind of team that you can guard a lead against. Ooh, a back block now is being called on Danosaurus Rex. It's another power jam, Dublin.
Yeah, Snowy out in front, picking up lead. It looks like Dublin actually has pack advantage too.
That's right, and boy, this is coming at an opportune moment. Another, boy, that's great track awareness for Snowy right there. Dashing Trudy Snow was bumped out by Miss Kalichek, but Miss Kalichek stepped a foot over the line as well, right, as it happened. Now, there's some good offense by Mania. Mania has been, one of the stars of the game.
Powerful herself, certainly, whether wearing the star or the pivot cap.
Absolutely, and coming through now, dashing Trudy Snow has a 9-point jam working, goes outside, gets an additional 4, and Dublin now 126, Auld Reekie 108 through the pack. Finally, Danosaurus Rex, an initial pass
for Auld Reekie. And there comes the call off. Well done, Dublin. Three more points. 133 Dublin, 108 Auld Reekie. 22 minutes left.
Looks like Hardcore Alina on Twitter says exactly what I'm thinking. Dual track coverage equals no time to get coffee. If you want to talk to us, hashtag talk to, that's the number two, WFTDA. Speaking of coffee, I could certainly use some, and I'll be getting some afterwards. My goodness.
I think so. Pittsburgh is known for its coffee. I'm pulling that completely out of my purse because Pittsburgh's known for a lot of things, though. A famous sports town, and we have to give a shout out to the Steel City Roller Derby host league for the D2 playoffs and championships here. The 2007 International WFTDA D2 playoffs and championships. And international, of course, we've got Bear City from Berlin. We've got Paris, you will be seeing later on. These two teams, only less than 300 miles apart from each other. They have to cross the North Channel to play. But the respective capitals of Ireland and Scotland taking aim at each other right now in the blue Dublin, in the black Auld Reekie. Auld Reekie with the higher seed, but playing catch up now, being forced to play catch up as Dublin 133, Auld Reekie 108.
Yeah, Dublin really came out strong here in the second half. No signs of stopping right about now. We've got Bloody Harry out wearing the star for Dublin in blue. Sasha DeBoyle Pisco wearing the star for Auld Reekie, and Sasha is out.
Yes, this is what Auld Reekie need right now. Nice work getting through for Bloody Harry, but Sasha now into the pack on a scoring pass. Auld Reekie on the offensive end protects. Okay, 4 points. 4 points for Auld Reekie. They've got plenty of time. 21 minutes, 33 seconds left. Auld Reekie 112, Dublin 133.
Yeah, Dublin picking up lead jammer privilege more often so far in the second half than Auld Reekie. They're up 4-2. Auld Reekie, though, coming into some power jam trouble there, giving up 3 jammer penalties so far, and we're only 6 jams in.
Okay, jam 7 beginning right now. Thea wearing the star for Dublin, and Thea just going postal, as we say in the U.S., lead jammer for Dublin. This is Rosie Peacock for Auld Reekie, and they are playing catch-up.
Yeah, Thea's got about half a lap lead on Rosie.
And Thea doing the smart play, picking up 2. Dublin 135 now, Auld Reekie 112. And when you can neutralize Rosie Peacock, that's a successful jam.
Absolutely, absolutely. And talking about how you could have your own successes, for the 2017 International WFTDA Championships, which are happening in November, the 3rd through the 5th, in the city of Brotherly Love, which is Philadelphia, if you're not sure about that. Tickets go on sale Friday, August 25th at WFTDA.com/champs. You can be a success and buy your own VIP ticket for just $160. I'll go into a little bit more detail on that later.
I suggest you do it. Thank you, Elota. We're back to the action now. Danosaurus Rex jamming for Auld Reekie, pushing the front of the back. Dashing Trudy Snow is holding her midsection. She got a pretty serious shot delivered from the Auld Reekie defense. I mean, these teams are playing for keeps right now, no doubt about it. Pushing the front of the pack now, Danosaurus Rex, but she is bumped to the inside. Nice work by Malibu Stacy. But nothing doing. Both teams at full strength, Elota, and no room for jammers.
Yeah, Snowy really getting recycled back more often than not. She gets knocked out on the outside.
Ooh, and a shoulder.
Yeah, just like that.
A shoulder juke for Snowy. And, boy, Temple of Doom guessed wrong. We have a multiplayer block going against Lana Payne. But lead jammer for Dublin now. Dashing Trudy Snow. Jess Little bumps her to the outside. And through the pack now is Danosaurus Rex. That's the initial 4 points go up for Snow. No, 5 points for Dashing Trudy Snow. I don't know that she wants to go long, and the bench staff for Dublin agrees. 140 Dublin, 112 Auld Reekie.
Yeah, 18 minutes left to go here in the second half. Those two jammers, when they finally escaped from the pack, just looked exhausted.
It's been a physical game. And, you know, one of the things we've been talking about, the Auld Reekie defense, you don't want to give them time to set up. But same for Dublin. Mm-hmm. Okay, we're back to the action. Dublin with one blocker in the penalty box. Pack advantage for Auld Reekie. Rosie Peacock wearing the star, needing a big jam, going face to face, toe to toe with Mania. Mania holds the inside line, and bumping out on the outside is Dirty Legs Louise. And it's a no pass, no penalty. So out in front is Rosie Peacock, but they are not lead jammer. Oh, and it's
bloody,
a
Bloody Harry got sent to the penalty box for a cut track. She is sitting in the box with her penalty, with her pivot and her penalty.
Well, 30 seconds, and Dublin's going to have to try to stop the hemorrhaging right now. 5 points for Rosie Peacock, and they are quickly around the pack looking for more. Ooh, a takedown as the power jam is over. Bloody Harry now still needs to complete the initial pass, and Rosie Peacock just takes charge on Mania. Mania regroups. Nice work by the Dublin defense getting up to the front of the pack.
We've got Bloody Harry with the star in her hand. She's wearing the green helmet, wearing the blue jersey, just in case you're not sure where she is. Still trying to make her way through that pack while Rosie Peacock is on a 10-point streak.
That's right. And Auld Reekie with 122, Dublin with 140. Through the pack, finally, is Bloody Harry, stashing the star, putting it back on her helmet. And Rosie Peacock bumped to the outside. No penalties. Oh, there is a penalty called on a multiplayer black on Mania. Oh, it's a scoring pass completed by Bloody Harry. Dublin needing all the points they can get right now. As Rosie Peacock, once they get a couple of points, it seems like they want more. Four more for Auld Reekie. Auld Reekie on 126, Dublin 144. Bump out at an opportune moment by Brutali Locock. Forces a reset by Rosie Peacock. Two more for Dublin. 146, Dublin 126, Auld Reekie.
Yeah, Auld Reekie with the big 14-point jam, but still not able to take that 20-point lead from Dublin. A lot of penalties there for both teams. At least two blocker penalties picked up by Auld Reekie in the midst of that. And at one point, not only did Auld Reekie have a power jam, so Dublin's jammer was in the box, but also was their pivot and another blocker. So Auld Reekie had significant pack advantage at one point during that power jam.
Yeah, and you got to think at this point, it's an early morning. There's a time differential. Fortunately, it's the it's the same for both teams. Mm-hmm. It's you know, currently, you know, I guess 4:30 or so, maybe 4 o'clock or so in Dublin and Edinburgh. So whatever disadvantage the teams are feeling from the time zone difference, at least they're feeling it the same. But at this point, with such a hard-fought game, this official timeout is really helping both teams.
And you know, this official timeout allows me to let you know that WFTDA is partnering with the UN Women for the We Believe program. Through our international giving program to support global change, We Believe, the WFTDA, is raising $15,000 for UN Women's One Win Leads to Another program, which uses sports to develop leadership and economic skills in young women and girls. You can find out more about We Believe and the WFTDA's partnership at UN Women, with UN Women, rather, and that would be at wftda.com/donates.
Well, if you're fortunate enough to have a couple extra shekels, I happen to be, and I've already donated to the program, but it's such an important part of the WFTDA's mission. Oh, we've got a point verification right now. That was the reason for the official timeout. There's no change. Dublin still with a 20-point lead with 15 minutes, 58 seconds left here. 146 Dublin, 126 Auld Reekie.
And you know, when we came into the start of the second half there, things were pretty even between these two teams as we ended the first half there. So far, Dublin's really kind of taken it away. They've picked up lead jammer privilege 6 out of the last 9 jams. And so that's left 3 jams for Auld Reekie to pick up lead jammer, but they've also given up 3 penalty jams.
Yes, Sasha DePaul Pisco now ready to go for Auld Reekie, taking on Thea for Dublin. Both teams with a skater in the penalty box. Standing up right now is Mania for Dublin. We'll see whether the jammers can profit from having a smaller pack to contend with. Pushing the front of the pack. Now we have a lead jammer awarded to Sasha DePaul Pisco.
She was able to make her way through that two-blocker wall there up front, but there was a multiplayer block, so Dublin lost one of their blockers as one was coming in.
Sasha with a quick 5 now, cutting into that Dublin lead. Thea takes the star off her helmet, but is having difficulties, and Sasha DePaul Pisco taking complete control of this jam right now. Dublin passing the star to Mania. 10 points in the back pocket for Sasha. She's looking for a couple more before making the call. Mania's into the pack, though. Dublin's going to be getting some points. Mania ridden inside by Jess Little. And 140, Auld Reekie, 146, Dublin. Oh, Mania somehow keeping herself in play.
Yeah, she watched her skates the entire time as she passed around turn 2.
Woo! Calling it off now, Sasha DePaul Pisco, and we are getting very, very close. That's an 18-point jam for Sasha. 144, Auld Reekie, 150, Dublin.
And 14 and a half minutes left to go in the second half. You know, we saw a handful of star passes in the first half where they were really necessary to force that call off by the other team. We have not seen one in quite a while. It's the first one here in the second half.
Dublin with one blocker in the penalty box. She is standing. Full complement of skaters for Auld Reekie. 144 Auld Reekie, 150 Dublin. 14 minutes left in the game. Making a move to the outside is Danny Soros Rex, lead jammer Auld Reekie. Auld Reekie looking to pull back into the lead right now. It looks like there's a little bit of room on the inside, but the Dublin blockers immediately seal that off. And coming through the pack now, it's dashing Trudy Snow, completing the initial pass for Dublin. And Danisaurus Rex now has to call off the jam after picking up 2. Woo! 146 Auld Reekie, 150 Dublin.
Yeah, Auld Reekie's coming back with lead jammer privilege there on the last couple of jams and slowly chipping away at Dublin's 20-point lead. They are now just being 4 above Auld Reekie.
Okay, cut track called on Auld Reekie's blocker as we go into jam 11. Auld Reekie only with 2 blockers on the track. Big pack advantage for Dublin.
Yeah, but let's be honest, Auld Reekie's defense has been tight so far.
Even with 2, one of them's Jess Little, and Jess Little trying to hold the outside, can't do it. Bloody Harry, lead jammer Dublin, and Rosie Peacock with the star for Auld Reekie completes the initial. Here comes Bloody Harry now on a scoring pass, and whatever she does, she's going to have to do it quickly because Peacock into the pack. Couple of points picked up for Bloody Harry, nothing for Auld Reekie. 152 for Dublin, 146 Auld Reekie.
12 and a half minutes left to go in the second half. Again, you are watching Auld Reekie, the number 1 seed coming into this 3-day tournament of both playoffs and championships here in Pittsburgh, hosted by Steel City. Dublin coming in the 16th seed. They are on top and on fire.
They are shaking things up, and if this is a harbinger of things to come, it's going to be an exciting weekend. Mania wearing the star for Dublin, Sasha DePaul Peacock for Auld Reekie, and Mania is through, lead jammer Dublin. We have a star pass now.
We have an attempted star pass.
Exactly.
Yeah, that got the star got dropped there somewhere in the track.
Ooh, boy, it was getting tough for Mania, but Mania able to wriggle through the pack, picking up 4 points. Mania now going to call off, trying to run as much clock as possible. There's 11 minutes and 25 seconds left. Dublin 156, Auld Reekie 146. Ilota.
It looks like Auld Reekie held scoreless in the last two jams, with Dublin picking up lead jammer privilege, both of those.
Yeah, these next 11 minutes are for a lot more than just moving on in the D2 championships here in Pittsburgh. It's for some national pride between the Scottish capital and the Irish capital. Dublin versus Edinburgh. It is Auld Reekie sending Rosie Peacock to the jam line. Thea wearing the star for Dublin. Thea pushing the front of the pack, but here comes Rosie. They look for an inside track, and they're going to be called off for a forearm. You could see that. It was right in front of our broadcast booth, and Thea hoping to push these. Dublin currently playing passive offense, and Jess Little likes to see that. This is a good penalty kill so far for Auld Reekie.
Yeah, you know, Auld Reekie really setting up with that brace triangle, but their blockers are also doing a great job of just rolling off one another. So that every time Thea thinks that she's passed one, the next one is rolled off, and it's just this constant cascading of blockers that's holding Thea back and is basically burning that penalty because we've got Rosie standing.
Yeah, essentially taking care of that power jam. And again, this Auld Reekie defense is just amazing to watch. Very well coordinated. The power jam is over. Here comes Rosie Peacock. And with 45 seconds left on the jam clock, anything is possible. Peacock is through. That's an initial pass. Thea still not through on an initial pass. And boy, Dublin really needs to hold off now. Rosie Peacock going airborne. Apex jump, 5 points. Auld Reekie 151, Dublin 156. And Thea now looking to pass the star. And
it's a star stash.
Correct. But meanwhile, Rosie Peacock is just motoring past Thea.
1 point now separating these two teams. Dublin 156 holding on a slim, razor-thin lead. Auld Reekie 155. Points on the board right there. Lead change to Auld Reekie, 158, Dublin 156. That jam brought to you by Auld Reekie's defense.
That is correct. 1 point put up by the, you know, and we are coming down to crunch time, as we like to call it. Timeout called by Dublin. Very smart use of a timeout. This is the first timeout that Dublin has used in the game, and I think they really need this right now.
Yeah. All right, it looks like we've got Auld Reekie has lost Miss Kalichek due to penalties. We've also got Lana Payne with six there for the Dublin team.
Yeah, penalties starting to add up for both.
Rosie Peacock, five penalties.
Ooh, yeah. Yeah, Mania with four. And if there's one skater that Dublin can't afford to lose right now, that would be Mania. Really seems to have been a spark plug for the ladies in blue throughout this game. Dublin, if I may, just make one comment. Waited too long to engage their active offense on that last power jam, and it gave Auld Reekie an opportunity to set up, and boy, they didn't look back.
Yeah, at this point, it's really hard to just kind of watch. For me, it's hard to watch a jammer fight when your score is this close and you're now at just about 8 minutes left to go in the second half.
That's right. Sasha DeBolt-Pisco now jamming for Auld Reekie, dashing Trudy Snow for Dublin. And Sasha finds room on the inside. She got beat up in the early part of the jam, but she is lead jammer for Auld Reekie. Auld Reekie looking to extend the lead now. 160 on the board for them. Here's the Dublin defense at the front. Oh, my goodness, a forearm penalty. It's a power jam for Dublin, but they've got to spring their jammer. Oh, it's a star pass. Low block is the call on Skinner alive, and now wearing the star is Staba for Dublin. This jam is going to go the full 2 minutes. We've got a minute on the jam clock. Neither jam are going to be able to stop this, and we're going to see what kind of jamming chops Staba has. Wow, first time with the star. She gets five. And just a depleted blocker force out there now for Auld Reekie. And Staba breaks right through that two wall. That's another quick 5 points, Alota.
Yeah, and that 10 points is going to serve them well, bringing them back into the lead right now. We've got Sasha, though, out of the box with 5 points on the board for Auld Reekie.
Oh, look at Staba up on one skate in the straightaway. That is another scoring pass.
Yeah, boy, one skate, 4 points.
Both jammers put up four now.
It looks like we've got 15 seconds left to go in the jam.
Ooh, nice goal line stand defense there by the pivot for Auld Reekie. And that'll, oh no, another penalty this time. We're looking for the call. I believe it's another forearm, a low block on Sasha. And this is going to start jam 16 in a power jam for Dublin. We're waiting for all the points to be awarded here. Dublin 175, Auld Reekie 172. 6 minutes, 28 seconds left, Alota.
Yeah, and you know, Kara Elise on Twitter says, have I mentioned how much I love D2? Me too.
We love being here, bringing you the game. If you want to talk to us, check us out at WFTDA. Bloody Harry now wearing the star for Dublin, trying to play some offense for her as Ellie beating. But that Auld Reekie defense is nothing to sneeze at. Ooh, do we have a lead jammer? We do. This is Bloody Harry in control of the jam right now. Sasha DeBolpisco is standing up in the penalty box, scoring pass for Dublin now.
And you know, Bloody Harry, the top scoring jammer so far for Dublin.
Well, you know, everybody has had a run during this game for both teams. We've seen some great play pretty much all the way around. The power jam is over. Sasha DeBolpisco pushing the back of the pack, though. Dublin with a stand of defense of their own, Alota.
But, yeah, I was going to say, look at Bloody Harry up there in turn three, pushing against that braced two-wall, braced tripod there that Auld Reekie has used so often today and worked so well for them.
Yeah.
They've pushed her to the outside of turn three and knocked her back to the backstretch.
Oh, and a star pass now to Jess Little. Yeah, and quickly calling it off, Bloody Harry picked up four more. Nothing for Auld Reekie. Let's wait and see. Yes, 179 Dublin, 172 Auld Reekie, 4 minutes, 45 seconds to go.
And for anyone who's just turning in right now, just to do a quick recap, Auld Reekie, the number one seed coming into this D2 weekend. Dublin, the number 16 seed. Dublin on top, 179. Auld Reekie, 172.
Amazing. We've got one blocker in the penalty box for Dublin as we start jam 17. This is Rosie Peacock wearing the star for Auld Reekie. It's Thea wearing the star for Dublin, and Rosie Peacock has been the difference maker for Auld Reekie so far. Peacock pushing the defense on the inside. Thea looking outside, though, and she is lead jammer for Dublin. Peacock completes. No. Complete? They do complete the initial pass. But here comes Thea. Nice, quick direction change going from outside to inside. Big win on that jam for Dublin. 183 Dublin, Auld Reekie 172.
And we're 15, 16 jams in here. We had one that went the full 2 minutes there, one or two that went the full 2 minutes. But Dublin picking up lead jammer privilege twice as often as Auld Reekie.
Okay.
So where you could talk about Auld Reekie's defense being fantastic, Dublin's really putting it into overdrive and picking up that lead jammer privilege, which gives them a certain strategy right from the start.
They have accelerated their offensive game, Elota. You are correct. We have an official review being requested by Auld Reekie right now. They've got one timeout left. Okay, with 3 minutes, 41 seconds to go in this game, Dublin with an 11-point lead. We'll get you more information about the official review. Let's go, worst-case scenario for Auld Reekie if they do not. Okay, we are waiting to hear what the... Okay, we thought that the head referee was... Okay, we're hoping that you heard that. Auld Reekie is requesting that Dublin not be awarded lead jammer for the previous jam. That's a, boy, what's the remedy for that, Elota?
We take away a tally mark. Because we certainly can't take away the fact that they called it off.
The points are up there.
Yeah, the points are up there. I can't imagine that's going to change. So while they kind of hash that out, I'm going to get back to where I talked earlier about that there are VIP tickets for championships. Those go on sale next Friday, August 25th, at WFTDA.com/champs. The three-day VIP ticket is $160, and that ticket gets you reserved seating in the best seats in the house, lounge with a private bar just for VIPs, exclusive Sunday final countdown party during the last game with complimentary drinks, a 2017 championship program, and a VIP badge and lanyard. You know, the first time I ever went to Champs, it was in Philly, I think back in
2009.
So, yeah, I look forward to kind of coming full circle.
Philly's a fun town. I mean, of course, I'm from Pennsylvania. So, okay, we are going to have an official award. Okay, the lead call will stand. Auld Reekie will not retain their official review. The call is that I believe it was Bloody Harry had already passed the one blocker that then went out. So, oh my, Auld Reekie with their backs against the proverbial wall a little bit with 3 minutes, 38 seconds left. They're down by 11. They've got one clock stoppage left, one timeout. But in their behalf, they have Rosie Peacock wearing the star going against dashing Trudy Snow. Nice defensive play there by Chen Kleta, rolling back Rosie Peacock. And right now, Dublin focusing on defense, trying to keep Rosie Peacock in the back of the pack. Nice bump out there by Staba. Neither jammer doing much right now, Elota.
Yeah, but that kind of like first turn again, that neutralizer there for the jammers. Rosie's going to pick up lead. Meanwhile, we've got Snowy still there in the front stretch, unable to make her way through anything.
Looking
that brace triangle from Auld Reekie once again, doing what it's supposed to do.
Looking to pass the star is dashing Trudy Snow. Oh, and we have another jammer penalty on Rosie Peacock.
That's going to bring Rosie to six.
Now Dublin need to get through, get an opportunity to score some points before Rosie gets back on the track. The star has been passed to Staba. Oh, my. We're getting down to 2 minutes and 15 seconds left. Here comes Staba. This is an initial pass. Nice spin move getting them around.
Yeah, Temple of Doom, that last blocker standing there.
Oh, and Temple of Doom did well to keep herself on the track. The power jam is over. And this is an initial pass. Rosie Peacock without points. Both jammers in scoring position. Staba trying to play defense. And we have a collision on the straightaway. Peacock pushing the front of the pack. And who can stop her for Dublin? It would appear no one. That's a four-point pass, but 3 points picked up by Staba. Oh, my. 1 minute, 30 seconds left. Dublin 186. Auld Reekie 176.
Yeah, Rosie Peacock, definitely. You have said this a number of times and well-deserved. Just coming out and doing a great job for Auld Reekie, but also falling into penalty trouble. 6 penalties so far. And Rosie's a very physical skater. It could very well be in part why they pick up so many points, but it comes at a cost.
It's now a 6-point game. And coming to the front of the pack is Sasha DeBol Piska. She is lead jammer for Auld Reekie. Here
and a
comes
star stash there from number 90.
That's Mania. Oh, my. Do we have a penalty on Sasha? It appears that we do. And Mania now in a power jam.
So 5 points on the board for Mania right now, bringing Dublin to 191. 33 seconds
Dublin,
left to go.
Dublin can
clock.
Win this game. Dublin need to be very careful. They have enough of a lead. Mania is a spark plug. She's a wonderful skater. Does she have the discipline to simply hold off? There cannot be a stoppage. It is 15 seconds left. Dublin with 196. Reekie with 180. And this will be the final jam. The period clock is down to 6. And amazingly enough, the power jam is over. But Pippa does a nice job holding the outside line. The period clock has expired. Both jammers being rolled back. Dublin 196, Reekie 180. Lots of action in the pack.
35 seconds left on the jam clock right now. We're running on jam time only.
That's right. Sasha makes it through, and Mania is trying to be careful. Sasha going up, trying to jump the apex of turn one, unable to do so, now being rolled back alertly by the Dublin defense. And Mania has been called off. Mania is going to be
10 seconds just about left here.
Completing this jam
on the jam
in
clock.
The penalty box. Yes. And now Jess Little is called off. And oh my, Sasha. Well, at this point, Sasha has to push for whatever they can get. But that is it, folks. A big upset unofficially. We are waiting for the official word right now, but this is just going to blow the roof off of the Division
200
two.
Points on the board right now for Dublin. Still calling it unofficial.
Amazing.
But that is fantastic. The 16th seed comes in, upsets the number one seed.
Upsetting is, almost too kind a word. Amazing play. It appeared that Auld Reekie was going to establish themselves early in this game, but Dublin fighting back. We now have the official final score. Dublin 200, Auld Reekie 183.
Yeah. What a fantastic way to start this weekend. I am so pumped. Like, I was ready before, but I'm so ready to be here for 2017 International Wftda Division II Playoffs and Championships all in 1 week, and we just saw the 16th seed upset the number one seed.
Yeah, let's take a look at the scoring. How about it for Dublin? Bloody Harry, Dashing Trudy Snow with 82 points. Rosie Peacock, the leading scorer by a lot for Auld Reekie with 109.
Yeah.
But here go the Dublin Rollers Derby All-Star, the charter team. They are taking a lap of love. And right now, talk about love. Dublin loves Pittsburgh. I don't know how Auld Reekie feels.
So I was going to say, we've got the winner of this game, Dublin, at 200 points, playing later today at 6 p.m. They'll take on the winner of No Coast or Ohio. And then
which is next up on track one, I believe.
Yep. So you'll make sure you want to watch that to see who Dublin is going to be taking on. And then Auld Reekie will be playing at 8 p.m. tonight, taking on the winner of Oklahoma versus Naptown.
Amazing. Amazing game for both teams, but Dublin pulling out the win, having the discipline at the end of that game to maintain a slim lead and extend it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Okay, well, are your brackets busted? Let us know. Talk to us at hashtag talk to WFTDA. I'm Gretchen Little.
I am still a load of sarcasm.
Okay, and we want to thank Scar Trek, our producer, for making us sound as smart as we sounded. It was an uphill push for you,
it was.
Trek.
Thank you. Thank you so much for believing in us.